so we are. We have our money back. My Ellie, my Ellie, my Ellie. So we are. We want our money back. That's so some years ago. Stealing 400 people. All on any country to black. Who we carry complete up. Continue one for free ball. We all are quality people. That like kind of story my people will listen to. Student not go read the school. Not bring the 60 billion. Now people follow in the street. Bring the 60 billion. Paper people in the green. Bring the 60 billion. We just say my benefit. Bring the 60 billion. We want a 60 billion. To make an amero. We want a 60 billion for people in the back row. We want a 60 billion. See you ever get the people. That's why it's not a joke.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, men and women. Welcome to Attorney Commander Galpohkpa Chesson Talk Show. Today is Thursday, December the 16th, 2021. Last night, Michael Solomon had his announcement reception of his candidacy for the mayoral position of Providence City. And it was crowded, man. It was a nice event. Karen and I were there. You saw the picture we put up here. So we supported Mike because he's a community man. He has been a friend of the Liberian and African community for a while. The owner and proprietor of the rib joint in Onaville, a popular landmark in Providence and Rhode Island. So Mike is no stranger to us in our community. And it's about time we show him some love by going out there and voting for him to be the next mayor of the city of Providence, this great city of Providence. Okay, let's get to what's happening around here. Oh, for the people in Johnston, Rhode Island, let me tell you, your buses, your school buses will be running this morning. Your principal say, school superintendent say all week, all month, that you shouldn't have no more problem with transportation. There are a few people that will still need to transport themselves to school. So contact your school department and find out whether you're among those that's supposed to be transporting yourselves. But for the rest of you, I'm sure you know, because it's about time to be at the bus stop. So have a good day. Enjoy your bus rides. Mask mandate begin in Rhode Island next week on Monday. The governor has laid out certain procedures of how this mandate is supposed to be carried on. Testing, mask, vaccination. So those are the three proponents to the governor's mandate for next week. You either wear a mask, you test it, or you have been vaccinated. So find out about it. Make sure you stay in compliance with the governor's orders, and I'm sure people in the state of Rhode Island will enforce it. And take heed and govern yourselves accordingly. Okay? The fat test coach of North Kingston, Aaron Thomas. This guy for 20 years, this guy has been testing people naked, having all the basketballers get butt naked, say he testing them, going there finagling with a layer and pancaking, playing with a layer pancaking, pushing it up and down, looking all under it. So they started investigating him. Now he busted for inappropriate touching. Okay? So I knew I was going to boil down to this. Once they caught him for, they brought him up for this fat test, people getting naked, going to in front of him for fat test for 2 decades. This may be doing the thing in the schools. That's a problem. Okay? Why nobody phone about it, nobody talk about it, not investigating it. Okay? Let's move on from that. Today, it's unusually warm. Right now, it's 57, 58 degrees in Rhode Island. And temperature today is supposed to be going up to 61. So this is a spring day. Enjoy it. My topics for today: Liberian officials receiving personal money for signing and or passing multinational corporations agreements is a novelty. 2, the illicit and criminal behaviors of Liberia's government officials must cease and desist. And 3, Liberians must stand up. Okay. Liberian officials receiving personal money for signing and or passing multinational corporations agreements is a novelty. This is my first time hearing it. I've never heard Liberian government officials getting personal money for signing contract or passing contract in our country. When did this begin to happen? When did the president of Liberia get personal money for signing a contract? $30,000, $40,000. This is unheard of. When did our legislators get $50,000, $60,000 for passing a contract? This is unheard of. This is unheard of. Where all the stealing coming about? People just going in Liberia and inventing their own laws. When our president started getting money for signing contract, all that money for the Liberian people. Our government officials do not get monies for signing contracts personally. They don't. This is not America. I have never heard of our government officials getting money. If they did, they never told us. We never knew about it. And that was stealing. If they did, that was stealing. And this is stealing now. Why you have got to steal for our people like this? Where in Liberia law and constitution we allow our government officials to get money for signing contracts? Where? This is a novelty. It's something new, because it's new. It gotta be new. We don't do this in our country. Our people are suffering and dying, and we need every damn penny to lift them out of poverty. I was looking through the Providence, I mean front page, Africa, see the Indian man providing water and electricity for our prison. I mean, this is how bad Liberia is now. The Indian man feeding us, now he providing electricity and water for the prisoners in the prison. So that means they're not washing the prison. That means that place is funky and nasty. If people got to provide water and electricity, what's happening in our country? Our government officials receiving thousands and thousands of dollars, and our people are suffering, no water, no light, even in the prison, to clean the prison, no water. They were complaining about food for the prisoners. What's going on in our country? What's going on in the West African Republic of Liberia? This is insanity. It is damn right insanity for government officials to be receiving thousands and thousands of dollars and foreigners taking care of our prisoners in prison and electricity and water. That means our country has failed us. I mean, this is pure stealing. Our leaders are rogues. There is no other explanation for this. People receiving money for signing contract. We hearing US $50,000 giving to legislators to pass the Acela-Mattel agreement. Then this other inflated budget without anything to back it. Then our president living like a little playboy. People stealing our money, giving it to their relatives. I mean, what's happening in our country? What is happening in Liberia? Shit going crazy. This is unrealistic. The stealing is unrealistic. It can't be, man. It can't be. We hear all the news about the corruption and the deception and the lying and the criminality. It got to cease and desist. It's not right. It's not right. All the people receiving money, that money got to go back to the Liberian people. We got to punish these people. These people living above the laws of the Republic of Liberia. Not only the laws, they're living above the people of the Republic of Liberia. And this is not right. This is not what we get government for, to steal and rob from us and live above us and live in affluence. Look at George Weah. What do you think this government is, a little government? This is real Idi Amin shit. This is Idi Amin shit. This is shit Idi Amin used to do that they ran him out of his country. So that means we got to run George Weah out of our government. We can't go on like this. We cannot live like this. We need help. We need help. If our people cannot come to their own consciousness and realize that all of this is not in the best interest of the Liberian people, something wrong with us. Let me take a coffee break and move on, because something is wrong. I mean, I listened to Costa the morning crying about how, what's wrong with us, man. Leadership so terrible. You know, you can't trust the legislators. All of them so damn blind and corrupt and greedy and useless. I mean, and the people have no compulsion, no consideration. They just killed 13 people. We just coming out of a prolonged civil war because of that same thing. Then the people come and do it worse than they did before. Worse. Like they didn't even We have been through nothing. Like nothing happened. Like everything just going on for normal. Our people didn't die in vain. Our people died in vain. And all this shit. This is bullshit. Pure bullshit. These people can't just be stealing like this. It is unnatural. And the Liberian people remain silent and take this. This is unnatural. Let me take my break and I'll go on to my next lesson. Okay? But I will not give up. I'm not like Ellen Johnson Sirleaf. I will not put my children in power. I will not sell Liberia. I'm still coming for you because I believe in my people. I believe in my people. I believe when my people get tired with the bullshit, they will rise up. They will say enough is enough. The stench in the country is unbearable. Our country looks like a slum. Then you got all these native bitches just stealing and stealing and stealing. Then the old Congo rogues from 1980, they got them under them, teaching them how to steal. It's unacceptable. All these people got to go to jail. All these people got to be punished, man. All these people got to go to jail. Our country is not a country for rogues. It's not a country for criminals. It's not a country for murderers. This got to cease and desist. We got to put these people in jail. We got to put these people in jail. Take heed, my people, take heed and rise up. We can't go through this. This is outright stealing. This is the same shit Doe did. This is the same shit Doe did that led us into a war. We can't go through it again. Somebody got to put an end to this. This is not right for our people and country. We can't continuously suffer as a few people benefit from the wealth of our country. We will lose. Why we gotta lose all the time? Look how we lost in the past. To get rid of these people, we destroy everything we had. Now we come here again with the same bullshit. We can't keep destroying everything we got, man. We can't keep destroying everything we got. We can't. To get rid of these people, we can't. We need good governance. We need good leadership. We need people who love our country above themselves. The time of the Liberian people is now. The time of the Liberian revolution is now. The true revolution, not that bogus shit. We gotta free our country, man. We can't go through this. We can't go through this, man. Come to your senses, my people. Come to your senses, open your eyes. Come to your senses, my people. We can't continue to take two steps forward and five steps backwards. We cannot do that. It hurts, it hurts, it hurts. Stop it, stop it, stop it. Let me take my break. The illicit and criminal behaviors of Liberia's government officials must cease and desist. We can't go on with this kind of behavior. This kind of outright stealing, this kind of outright disregard for the laws and decency of our society, this outright criminality of our Liberian leaders must cease and desist. We gotta put these people in jail. We got to flog these people and put them in jail. We got to send a loud and clear message throughout the Liberian society that we will not take this bullshit no more. And we must have a leader that will implement this. We're unfair, we're all fashion, we're all bullshit, we're all retreat. We gotta punish these people. We gotta be merciless and punish these people. That's the only way the stealing will stop. That's the only way the corruption will stop. That's the only way we'll be able to build a system where all of us will enjoy. There's no way we can live in a system like this, man. We are trapped. Can you imagine? You have no way to get money, man. You young children, you have no way to get money. If your people don't give you money, you don't work for the government, you don't steal, you can't get money. You can't get money. That our society corrupt, because there's no way for young people to just get up and be independent in our country. There's a stigma on us. There's a finger thumb on you from the day you're born to the day you die. We can't go through this. Look at America. You can get up and say, I tried with my mom. I'm moving to another area. And you will live. Because you got jobs. Because you can earn a living. You can't do that in Liberia. If it's not your mom, your cousin, your auntie, some relative will hold you down. We can't do that, man. We got to open up our country so people can get out and live. So our family hold us down. Our family hold us down. When they say, oh, we turn against you, they block you. And I want to change that. I want everybody to have the opportunity to tell other people, fuck you. I'm moving on. You can't hold me back. And move somewhere else and live and prosper well. Why we gotta stay in our country and people put their thumbs on us and we can't G or we can't haul? Yeah? Why? We live in a country, no money. No money. No money. And so now people gotta do drastic things to get money to try to set their lives in a better direction. But this shouldn't be the way for us, man. This shouldn't be the way for us. It's only this way because our leaders are damn criminals and rogues. It's only this way because our leaders have no consideration for the rest of us. They just care for them and their families. That's all. And we've got to stop that. We've got to turn the hands of time on Liberia's leadership. This illicit, corrupt, criminal, evil behavior must cease and desist now. And when we start flocking them, when we start lining these fools up and flocking them for stealing, mercilessly flocking them for deception, mercilessly flocking them, our country will get on the right path. You know, our country will be on the right path. You know, in the midst of poverty, our people suffering, the man sitting on their riding car, bringing car to the country to impress people. When are the little children you're trying to impress, but the real people who suffer, who paying the rent and stuff, we can't tolerate it. Look at the NEC. The boss is guilty for giving her brother-in-law, her brother money, all that money, $90,000 for what? For what? But this is what we go through. This is what we go through when we do not stand up for ourselves. And that's my next topic. Because there is no way our country will change. And we sit so pliantly and let these people do this consistently and continuously. Will our country not improve? We're not going nowhere. we will be stagnant as we are forever. So I got a short class this morning. Let me take my break and start my last topic. We gotta stand up for ourselves. We can't see the wrong going on continuously. We can't see the wrong going on consistently. We know that our leader can't read and write. He got a big doctor degree and all that shit. It ain't mean nothing. The man can't speak. The man can't read, can't write. Then we see the man just wasting our country's money. This massive corruption and stealing just going on. And we can't do nothing about it. We can't say nothing about it. We can't stop this shit. It's not right. Liberians gotta stand up, man. We got to learn to stand up. Because if we don't, our country will continue to remain as it is. I mean, you're not tired seeing our people in mud? The highway going from here to, look at this, is the rainy season now. The mud up to here. People standing in the mud. The mud is mountainous. And they're standing in mud. You're not tired seeing that? I'm tired. All my life I've been seeing that. When I see Liberia, I just see mud and dirt and trucks held up because of mud. Our grow. We can't grow. It stalls our economy. When we cannot move our goods and services in the country from one area to the next with ease, it damages the economy of the country. That's why our country can't grow and prosper, because we have no roads. We cannot access goods and services. We have no roads. And we got to stand up. We can't go on like this. We got to stand up against this damn government that's stealing our money. We got to stand up and tell them, enough is damn well enough. Step aside and let's go to jail. We can't go on like this. We can't go on like this. Too many people have died in the name of change. Too many people have died in the name of freeing our people. Too many people have died for Liberia to grow. And we can't let them die in vain. We cannot let them die in vain. I can't talk for the other people, but I can talk for my pa. I can't talk for the other people. I can talk for my pa, and that's why I'm speaking. So other people can rise up and speak for their people like men. And let us get rid of these criminals, these damn nepotistic rogues and fools. Let's get rid of them and put them in jail. Liberia for us. Liberia not for these people. We in the majority. We got to guide our blessing. We got to guide our blessing. We got to guide our blessing. And we must start by punishing these damn rogues. Punishing these damn rogues. Or else our country will forever remain hostage to evil. Aluta! Continue on. My class is done. Have a good day. I'll see you tomorrow. In the cause of the people, the struggle continues in the cause of the people.